Hi, welcome once again. In this video we will see what are the material expressions that deal with depth of the pixel being rendered. The depth fade expression is used to hide unsightly seams that take place when translucent objects intersect with opaque ones. Now see the inputs. Opacity, this takes in the existing opacity for the object prior to the depth fade. Next is fade distance, this is world space distance over which the fade should take place. Once the effect is in place, you will notice that the cube which was fully gray, now becomes transparent at the lower side. Now the transparency is equal to the Unreal units that is entered in the fade distance. This effect will come when the translucent objects intersects with opaque ones. Here we have added two scalar constant to both the inputs of depth fade. We will modify these scalar figs and check the effect. So we have already seen the sharpness of edges when the fade distance is set to 0, and quite diffused when the fade distance has some numbers. Now let's see how we can modify it in terms of colors in the fade distance zone. And again, just by changing the various channels and main material node, the depth fade color can be modified, as per your desire and requirement. Here in this example, the fade distance zone has a different color altogether. So again, the color can be played with by some modification in the material main node. The pixel depth expression outputs the depth, or distance from the camera, of the pixel currently being rendered. This expression supports positive values, and not negative ones. This is because the renderer relies on the conservative depth optimization to maintain good performance on modern hardware. This has the added benefit that if depth can move away from the camera, hardware depth rejection can be reused from the vertex shader output. Otherwise, allowing pixel depth offset to move towards the camera could cause objects to poke through anything, and the pixel shader would have to run the pixel shader for all pixels regardless of whether they are occluded without pixel depth offset or not. In this example, the material network has been applied to the floor. Notice how the linear interpolation blends between the two colors as the floor recedes beyond 2048 units. A power expression was used to boost the contrast between the two colors and yield a more meaningful visual result. Now in the example, what we can is a sudden change in color, which might not look appealing or desirable. So we can do some modification and have the effect more smooth and some blended colors reflecting in final result. So here in this example we have a plane with the same material added. So both the edges are of the same color at a certain distance. Now on changing the distance the color changes based on the pixels and the transition is smooth from original color to final color. Still the mesh will take up more than one color at a time, depending upon the distance you have entered. So after adding component mask, in another example, the transition to final color has different effect. Here the whole mesh is one color, and that color is basically the blend or transition of initial color to final color. The scene depth expression outputs the existing scene depth. This is similar to pixel depth, except that pixel depth can sample the depth only at the pixel currently being drawn, whereas scene depth can sample depth at any location. Only translucent materials may utilize scene depth. In this example, we have applied the material network to a translucent sphere. Notice how the scene depth node is reading the pixels behind the sphere, rather than the ones on its surface. The resulting normalized depth is linear in the 0.0 to 1.0 range. Hope from this video, you will start to move into building in more advanced mechanics, in an easy to follow step-by-step approach, which will allow you to play around and build your own content, to eventually build your own game. Thanks a lot. See you in the next video.